cranes, because they are monogamous. Beautiful birds, voice not so beautiful. Now, further north in Kenya, you get the northern crown crane, which is a little bit darker. There we go, finding some hohos to eat. It is quite ridiculous, that hairdo. Speaking of hairdos, we just chatted about the male lion's hairdo. Now looking at the crown crane, oh, there we go, you get that grasshopper. They are very, very pretty birds. Oh, well, our cranes keep... we got some... Oh, sorry, I got sidetracked there. We got some answers in. We've got Japan as an answer. I think Japan do have a type of crane as their national bird. I can't remember. It's not a whooping crane, but it's not the crown crane. The crown cranes are endemic to Africa. Someone else said Botswana. Unfortunately, Botswana is not right. Botswana and Kenya have the same national bird, which is the lilac-breasted roller. South Africa, of course, has the blue crane as its national bird, so not the crown crane. Now, in the early mornings here in the Mara, you hear them a lot. Honk, honk, honk. Not the most, the most lovely sound in the morning. Edu and Kathy, you are correct. Spot on, 100%. Uganda's national bird is the crowned crane. And, of course, I'm very excited. In a few short sleeps, Jamie and I will be going to Uganda, as well as with Rebecca and Batman. And, Rebecca and Batman are missing the birding section of the holiday. They're going to the beach in Kenya instead. But we're going to go look for shubles, which is a type of stork, and then go white water rafting. It's very exciting. And I'm sure we will see a lot of the crowned cranes while we travel through the beautiful country of Uganda. Now, who knows, while we're paddling our hearts out down the Nile River, we might encounter the animal that Tristan is still with.